On the bus ride to Baden-Baden, we went through the southern part of the Black Forest. On the way, the bus driver stopped for a few minutes to allow us to take pictures of the countryside and the villages below. The Black Forest is a large area, 90 miles by 30 miles, and is home to many villages and small towns. The area is also known for handmade cuckoo clocks and cake. This may look like any other forest if not for the stories of the Brothers Grimm and other storytellers that told tales, sometimes dark tales, crafted to teach young children lessons of morality.
So how did they become so influential? It might be interesting to know before I tell you the stories. They were poverty in the family, because when the head of the house died in those days, well, he was the main person who got the income and the salary. So they had to find something to do, and they were told all these stories, these oral traditions by their father. So in honor of him, they decided to stories going back to nature, going back to the traditions. So they were very lucky with their publication, and it became very famous very quickly and very rich very quickly. So they came pretty much like rags to riches. So they did that, and now they're still using them. Now, how it really ends in Grimm's fairy tales, the happily ever after thing is there as well, no problem there.
The name of the town, Baden-Baden, comes from the German word for bath, and for thousands of years the town's thermal springs have provided relief and cleansing to visitors and locals alike. The Roman baths, which still exist, were created by the Roman Emperor Caracalla to help ease his arthritis. The Russians have become attracted to this area and have been buying up properties, as evidenced by the Russian language in use in this real estate office. Other than the baths and a large technology museum, there's not much else here except for shopping. Dedicated in 1061, the Speyer Cathedral is the largest Romanesque basilica in all of Europe. Its crypt has existed undisturbed since 1041 and is the resting place of 8 German emperors or kings, 4 queens, and many bishops. The 180-foot-tall tower is one of the largest towers and gates remaining in Germany. The gate would have been destroyed in 1689 during the Nine Years' War, but local Carmelite monks begged the French not to demolish it and risk destroying their nearby monastery. This building would have been the Pope's residence if he ever had to leave the Vatican. The wide street leading to the cathedral was designed to provide an escape path for the residents to find refuge in the cathedral. We stopped here for some strudel and hot tea. In the Middle Ages, the town had an important and vibrant Jewish community, the remnants of which can still be seen today. The community settled in Speyer in 1084 and quickly built a ritual center with synagogues for men and women, as well as a mitzvah or ritual bath, the oldest of its kind still existing in Europe today. Speyer is the place where the pretzel was invented, so we had to buy one from a street vendor. After our walking tour of Speyer in the morning, we boarded a bus which took us to a nearby village for our home-hosted visit. Along the way, we saw many wind turbines. Our small group of six were fortunate to visit the home of Herman and Wilma. Herman is an artist and has been working in various media for some 36 years. Their comfortable home, which they designed themselves, is filled with his work and looks like an art gallery. The couple often opens their house to guests on weekends to view the artwork, and sometimes he sells a few pictures. But he told me that he paints more than he sells. After looking around the house and admiring the artwork, we sat down to enjoy a delicious cake that Wilma had prepared and some tea. The visit was very special and most enjoyable.